Hi, I'm Lauren Gertsen, and the first thing I want to say is congratulations, because if you found this video and you're struggling with food issues, then it means that at some level, you asked for this healing information, and at some level, your soul is calling in more healing around some of these food and body patterns that have led you to feel kind of stuck. So I'm going to ask you three questions, the same questions that I would ask you if we were on an intake call, and I really want you to sit with these and take them in. The first question is, does your relationship with food make you feel trapped, or does it make your life feel smaller? Second, do you want to experience trusting your body instead of dominating and controlling your body, even if that concept sounds kind of scary? And third, do you feel like your life would expand in some really beautiful and soul-fulfilling ways if your food issues didn't exist? If you gave me three solid yeses on those questions, then this video is going to be a really good fit for you. It's going to share some really eye-opening information to help progress your healing journey. I want to talk about the three signs that your long-term food issues are actually spiritual problems, not food problems. Okay, so the first sign that your food problems are actually spiritual problems is that you are hesitating or you're procrastinating on a major life change. A lot of women find me in my Food Without Fear program when they have this sense, this inkling that they need to make kind of a big change around their career, their education, their family life, their relationships, their sex life, their dating life, but they are procrastinating on their intuition. They're afraid of taking that first step forward because they're second guessing themselves, because they're afraid of the repercussions that might happen. They're afraid of the decisions that they're going to have to make afterwards, and they don't know if they can trust themselves to navigate that situation. So that's all really, really understandable. Those are understandable fears and hesitations. But the problem is that when we are in that state of hesitancy and procrastinating on what our gut is telling us to do, it creates a lot of stress and emotional distress. And so that's where our food problems can really worsen, because food is a coping mechanism, and controlling food and counting calories and being exercise obsessed, that's also a coping mechanism. So the long-term solution here is not to try to use willpower to get rid of your coping mechanism, because subconsciously it's still needed. What I help you do is get the clarity and the decisiveness and the self-trust that you need to navigate those big life choices with grace and with conviction and with purpose, right? Really tuned into the direction that your body's wisdom is calling you to go in your life. That's what creates freedom and healing. The second sign that your food problems are actually spiritual problems is that your symptoms aren't responding to dietary or supplement changes. So one of the first things that a lot of my clients tell me is, Lauren, I have tried literally everything and it's not working. Okay, so sometimes this is in regards to really chronic digestive issues, like really uncomfortable bloating, digestive problems, constipation, just things aren't going right in the digestive area. Okay, and they tell me that they have tried every elimination diet under the sun and every digestive supplement, right? And they've taken oodles of food sensitivity tests, okay, but it's not helping. So what that tells me is the problem is actually at the level of the nervous system, because what happens is when our nervous system gets locked into a fight or flight state, this can happen from past trauma. It can happen from our upbringing, especially if we get a lot of messages that our safety or worth is correlated to how much we produce, or if we look a certain way, or if we can manage to look perfect, right? That really wires into our subconscious mind that we are only safe if we're in that fight or flight state of the nervous system. Okay, the problem is it effectively shuts down your digestive system. So you can truly be doing everything, right? And what is going to happen is you'll take out some foods that you're allergic or sensitive to, and then your body will just develop new food sensitivities, and you can have really expensive pee because you're taking all these digestive supplements and they're just going right through you. So in that situation, we need to address rewiring your subconscious mind and allowing your body to shift into the parasympathetic or the rest or digest state of your nervous system. And I got a lot of tools to help you with that. On a similar note, a lot of people come to me and they tell me they have tried everything to lose weight. And like, they really have. They have tried more diets than I have heard of, and I have been in the health and wellness world for almost a decade, okay? So the problem here is that scientific literature comprehensively shows that dieting to lose weight, which means if you are restricting the amount of food you're eating, or if you're restricting the type of food you're eating, or if you're restricting the times that you're eating, okay, all of that follows under the umbrella of dieting here. It doesn't work. Really comprehensively, the scientific literature shows that it backfires. And in the long term, you're gonna gain that weight back because inevitably your willpower is gonna give out. That's not your fault. That is physiology. That is your body's survival mechanisms kicking in because your body senses that you're in a famine state. Now, the other thing that all this research on dieting shows is that it very comprehensively slows down your metabolism. Your body burns calories slower. So what we need to do in this state, if you have this history of dieting and if you have tried keto and intermittent fasting and Whole30 and Weight Watchers and everything else and it hasn't worked because you're watching this video and you're still having food problems, okay, then what we need to do is we need to get you back in touch with your body's hunger and fullness signals, okay? This is a process called intuitive eating. And the other thing we need to do is start healing your metabolism. So this does include some of the nervous system work that I talked about, rewiring your subconscious mind, helping your body shift into that parasympathetic healing state of the nervous system. Okay, that's a piece of metabolism healing. And the amazing thing here is when you can actually start eating intuitively and healing your metabolism, okay, emotional eating and binging ends. And I don't care how long you have struggled with that pattern, this is the way to get complete freedom around it. So I've had clients who've come to me and they've struggled with binge eating for 50 years. Okay, you know, they're 60, they're 65. They've had this pattern their whole life. When we take the steps to get them back in touch with their body's intuition around food and we help them heal that mentality of control rather than partnership with their bodies, it changes overnight, truly. Like within 8 weeks of working with me, they can heal their binging and emotional eating. And again, these are patterns they've struggled with for over 50 years. The third sign that your food problems are actually spiritual problems is that your growth might make some people uncomfortable. Most of the people that I work with, they're very empathic, sensitive, caring, compassionate individuals. They don't like to rock the boat. They are very considerate of other people. And this can sometimes hold them back in their healing. So I want you to think about your life and your relationship dynamics. And I want you to ask yourself, is there somebody in your life who might be unhappy, uncomfortable, or even insecure? If you become healthier physically, emotionally, mentally, sexually, or spiritually? I also want you to ask yourself, if you get more in touch with your spiritual and intuitive inner compass, is it possible that you might start to feel like an outsider in some of your social situations or some of your communities? This is the reason why we can often hold ourselves back subconsciously from our healing, because not everyone is going with us on this journey. And not everyone is going to be cheering for us as we do this transformative work. And some people are going to come with us, but they're not going to be able to fully see and recognize who we truly are because they haven't done that self-work themselves. Okay? And that's hard, but the truth is that you're also going to draw in new and beautiful relationships, new and beautiful life experiences, new and beautiful communities where you are radically seen and affirmed in ways that you have never experienced, right? Because the more you become your true self and express your true self, the more you draw in those people who have the ability to see that in you, to cheer for you, and the more you are able to do your healing soul work in the world. Something I often tell my clients is that self-repression, and I mean self with a capital S, like your true self, self-repression is a surefire way to guarantee chronic health issues and just feeling mysteriously sick and ill for a long time. Self-expression is your most powerful medicine, and I can give you a lot of tools for that powerful self-expression in the work we do together in the Food Without Fear program. Some of the work we'll do together is around boundary setting and communication, because these are the tools that you need to shift relationship dynamics, to express your true self, and to do so with grace and dignity on your healing journey. And that's really beautiful. And I really love that when my clients learn these techniques and they take the communication module that I teach, they can actually bring their family members into it. I've had whole families watch my communication module together when somebody in the family is taking the Food Without Fear program. That is so cool to see. Like, I actually get chills talking about it, because that is like major generational healing. When you change the way you communicate and you change your ability to set better boundaries, it truly is ancestral generational healing. If any of those 3 points resonated with you, then I would love to support you in the Food Without Fear program. This is an 8-week group program for spiritually minded individuals to permanently solve their lifelong food and weight issues. So in this program, I will give you a spiritual toolkit. You're going to get everything that you need to reconnect to your body's healing and intuitive wisdom, to start rewiring your subconscious mind around unhealthy beliefs and start shifting your nervous system, and to start energetically healing as well and releasing trapped emotions from your body so you can really fully self-express in your life and just allow in that next level of ease and freedom and joy. I say that food is the end to this program, but it's actually not the main focus. Yes, we do talk about it. I will give you the very specific steps of learning intuitive eating and being able to reintroduce foods that you haven't been able to before. But the main focus of this problem is the spiritual aspects that we've talked about in this video so far, because food can't solve a food problem, right? And if you feel out of control with your body or your weight or what you look like, well, controlling your body more isn't going to solve that problem either. We can't solve a problem at the level of consciousness that created the problem. We have to use a new way of thinking. We have to use a new consciousness, and that's what I help you do in the Food Without Fear program. If you are interested in this program, there are 3 things that I ask from you. The first one is that you have a willingness to let go of the thoughts and the beliefs that are hurting you. Okay? So this can include the thought that, you know, I'm a failure because I haven't been able to fix my food issues before, or I can't be happy unless I make my body look a certain way, or my body is my enemy, my body is not on my side. Now, I'm not asking you to change these beliefs right away. I'm not asking you to know how to change those beliefs. That's what I help you with in the program. I give you those subconscious rewiring tools. But what I do ask is that you have that willingness in your heart. You have that openness in your heart to let go of these beliefs that are hurting you. The second thing that I ask is that you create a morning or evening routine, you know, based on if you're a night or morning person, because I'm going to give you tools in this program that need to be done repetitively on a daily basis. That is what it takes to start rewiring your subconscious mind and shifting the state of your nervous system, especially if you have your nervous system locked into that fight or flight state. It takes daily repetition, right? It's like if you were trying to get stronger by going to the gym, you don't go once a month. You do it regularly. Same thing when you are rewiring your brain. The third thing that I ask from you is that you spend maybe 15 or 25 minutes and you envision what your ideal day is going to look like when you are completely at peace with food and your body, right? So what does that look like when you're not spending all of your psychic and mental energy planning your next meal or counting calories or researching diets and supplements? What happens when you free up that creative psychic energy? What happens when you just feel so magnetic and calm and peaceful and present in your body? What happens when you are in touch with that compass in your heart? And so you have clarity, you know what decisions you need to make in your life. I really want you to get into your imagination here, to do this exercise from your heart, not from your mind, because your mind is going to tell you, oh, that's not possible, or I can't create that in my life. Your heart is going to tell you, I have something so beautiful I want to share with you. And I want you to listen to that voice, okay? Add detail, add palpable details. What does it feel like? What does it smell like? How do you feel? What are your emotions in your body? Because the more vivid you can make it, okay, the more real you make it to your subconscious, Now, when that happens, your longing for this healing is going to become louder than your fear of change. And that is what catalyzes you to take the action steps to make this a possibility. I would love to see you in the next Food Without Fear cohort. You can go to foodwithoutfearprogram.com to enroll. And I am just so honored and excited to be a part of this new chapter of your healing journey.